So we are using TensorFlow because it can scale to big data, capture many types of feature transformations, and because it has implementations of many kinds of model architectures. What else does a machine learning framework need to provide? Hyperparameter tuning might be nice. When you do machine learning, you often pick a number of things arbitrarily. The number of nodes, the embedding, the stride size on your convolutional layer, the number of buckets in your embedding, and as your models get more and more complex, you start wondering whether you pick the right things when you train the model. You'll have to do some search in the hyperparameter space to see if there are better choices that you could have made. So hyperparameter tuning might be nice. So far, we focused on training on the top part of this diagram. But besides training, you might also want to autoscale prediction code, because at some point, you want to take a trained model and you want to deploy it. And at that point, the performance characteristic that you're concerned about changes. Instead of thinking about how long it takes to train on your training dataset, you start thinking about how many queries per second you need to support from your client code. This requires auto-scaling the prediction code as necessary to support the users who need those predictions. Do you want all your client code creating a DNN regressor, passing in the directory name, and calling predict on it? What if your model changes? What if the hyperparameters change? The number of inputs changes? Do you really want to expose this to your users? And what if the client is not Python? The answer is to wrap your model with a REST API. You can then invoke the API from pretty much any programming language. And you can put the server on the cloud and scale to as many queries as you need when you need it. But not as obvious is this question. Who does the preprocessing? Who will do the input transformations on behalf of the client code? You can't pass in the raw input variables to the trained model because a trained model expects scaled, transformed inputs. You also have to worry about model changes. When you do a bag of words, for example, with a certain word mapped to the number 32, the embedding might change in the next model run because your input data is larger, and now that word gets mapped to a different number, say the number 56. Similarly, in scaling, the minimum, the maximum, the standard deviation, these can all change. So doing the bookkeeping associated with pre-processing and feature crosses is painful, and it's a major source of error. It's also near impossible to debug, so there are probably many models out there that have a training serving skew. This difference between what it was trained on and what it's being presented at prediction time. Cloud ML Engine gives you the ability to carry out machine learning that is repeatable, scalable, and tuned. Repeatable? Well, you need a machine learning framework that helps you handle training serving skew. The use of TensorFlow Transform, for example, simplifies the bookkeeping in several common situations. It's scalable. In training, Cloud ML will help you distribute the pre-processing and training of your model. It will also help you deploy your trained model to the cloud. This is important because you need high-quality execution, both during training and at prediction time. And of course, you can use Cloud ML Engine to do hyperparameter tuning. The way that we will work is that we will start in Cloud Datalab, a Jupyter Notebook environment. We'll run SQL statements to aggregate the data in BigQuery and pull the data into a pandas data frame. We can then do exploration and feature selection and pre-processing using pandas, and we will write this pandas data frame out to CSV. And then we'll start experimenting with TensorFlow. And once we have a working TensorFlow model on this smaller data set, we can then scale it out to Google Cloud Platform. And we'll do this using serverless technologies. We'll do our pre-processing in Cloud Dataflow so that the preprocessing can be scaled out to many machines. And we'll create sharded CSV files on cloud storage. The TensorFlow model will remain the same, but we'll train the model on Cloud ML Engine so that we get distributed training. We'll do hyperparameter tuning and deployment also on ML Engine. So Dataflow and ML Engine, these are both serverless technologies. So all that we will need is Python code to submit to the services. So this is a set of labs that you will be doing. The first lab is to explore and visualize the dataset. That's what you'll do in the next module. But before we send you off to do the lab, we will talk about the problem itself and review some concepts before you go off to do the lab. Concepts that you will need in order to accomplish the tasks in the lab.